गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, सो वी स्टार्ट एट 5:30। इफ़ एनी वन हैव एनी डाउट देन दे कैन आस्क मी फॉर द सेशन गोइंग ऑन। सी सर्कल्स वी हैव कम्प्लीटेड इन लास्ट सेशन, इसलिए इफ एनी वन हैज एनी डाउट देन दे कैन आस्क विजय, भाविया, नवनीत इन सर्कल चैप्टर एनी
So
क्वेश्चन।
I posted some questions in the WhatsApp. Can
एक्चुअली
you
those
discuss
questions
that?
are those questions are from circle chapter.
Yes, sir.
One second.
So from Thursday onwards I sent, those are from circles chapter. I posted two questions.
Okay, see. Let me open that WhatsApp page here. This is one question, okay. This one, this is from triangle. Means height and distance, or you can say application of triangle. So you can see this question. This is also one circle question, okay. Third one. These are the three questions basically, right? We'll see one by one. See, in this question now, figure 8.10, they have given so AB is chord, okay fine, and chord to the circle AOC is its diameter, AOC no problem, angle AC be 50, AT is a tangent, AT tangent to the circle at point A, what is angle BAT? Angle BAT is equal to, everyone will solve this question. Ajit, Anushka, Navneet, Tanvi, screen shared, no, right? So please solve this question, and options are given 65, 60, 50, 40. Always, Bhavya, no, try to this now. One group also we can have in WhatsApp group also we can share, because last time we told no, other students can also try. Means,
sir, now I understood, I got the answer this time, I tried it again.
Others can also try, because
thank
already
you,
already we have opened this sheet. So Navneet, Apurva has also joining, because we can practice, because questions are exemplar is also good book, and most of the questions can, because this time the questions will be easy, but still it can be asked from exemplar book also, right? Navneet is getting 50 option, 50 means option C, and this one Tanvi is getting having answer this C option, Bhavya. Okay, fine. So we know this basic concept, because radius, this is radius and this is tangent to the circle. We know the basic concept, this will be 90 degree, and this is semicircle. This is this is chord AC is we can say longest chord passing through center. This will be basically diameter AC. So this will be at this diameter, now this angle will be 90 degree. So basically this is 50. So this will be 40, and remaining this will be 50 degree, no, not a problem. So this was the answer. Now we'll see next question. Same is at this now, at the diameter angle will be 90 degree, 50 is given to 40, and then a remaining will be 50, because radius is proportional to the tangent. Now we'll see next question. Let me take a snapshot of the solution. So this was the for your first question. Fine. Right, everyone is correct. Now this is your next question. Figure is also given. Figure is given here. Okay, this is the diagram. Let me take this question.
So the figure for the second
diagram.
question is the
Not
next
figure.
one.
This one is the diagram figure, okay?
Yes, sir.
No problem. So this question also everyone will try, because this is just for practice, we can say, and try to get the answer. Let me explain also.
So do they ask these type of questions in the board exam?
Chances are very less. Only NCERT, 3 to 4 times we can solve. Minimum 2 to 3 times we can solve, then we can move to other books. Basically, and this time questions will be easy, and mostly they will ask from NCERT book, mostly examples and exercise questions. So those students who have studied up this nicely in this year, no, more chances will be there to get 100 out of 100 score. Those questions will be directly from NCERT examples and exercise question, no variation, nothing will be there. In normal years also, questions are 95% questions are straightforward. And because this year we had COVID, so 100% question will be straightforward. So no need to worry. But still we need to practice to get maximum marks. So what will be the answer for this one? Fourth one we'll see. Let A be the one point of intersection of the two circles, two intersecting circles with center O and Q. This is one center, this is another center. The tangent at A of the two circles, meet the circle again at B and C. Okay, this is one tangent. It is meeting tangent one, meeting the circle, big circle at B, and this is another tangent. Tangent two, meeting this circle, small circle at C. Tangent two, smaller circle, meeting bigger circle at B. Tangent two, bigger circle, T2, meeting this small circle C. Prove that let P be the location located so that angle, so that AOPQ. Is a parallelogram. Prove that P is the circumference of the triangle ABC. P is circummeter, okay, of the triangle ABC. Circumcenter of the triangle ABC. So this is the triangle. What is first circumcenter? That we need to know, then we can find the, we can prove basically. Altitude meeting point is, we can say this now, ortho center, and median meeting point is centroid. So what is circumcenter? Angle bisector or something else?
It is the intersection of perpendicular bisectors.
Okay. Perpendicular bisectors of sides means basically, see, centroid we know. One second. Centroid is where median meets. Median meeting point or median meets. Then we have this now, ortho center. Where this? I'm not able to write. One second. Altitude meets circumcenter. One more in center is also there. Circumcenter is where perpendicular. Bisector of sides, which opposite sides they will bisect, means perpendicular, and they will bisect also. Means altitude plus median. Altitude means 90 degree plus median. Perpendicular bisector of sides meet. And what is in center? Angle bisector is called as in center, no? Right. Angle bisector is one more we have. Angle bisector is called as in center. So in center, you can also write. In center will be angle bisector. Fine. So this question I will try, and I will let you know the answer, because we have to see how we can prove this P point is. You can say P point is will be the meeting point of the distance sides bisector or perpendicular also. Fine. So these are the four cases. I'll try and share you the answer. No problem. These two questions were only there. Any other question from NCERT book we have? Shall we move to next chapter? One question, you can try last one. From circle chapter. Almost all the questions we have seen, important ones. One question, last one, we can try. This is question number. See, 12 was important. 12 we have seen. 12 we have seen, and then well, number we have seen 13. Total question 13 number. Okay. Eleven number we can try, last one. 11 number question can also come. Then we'll move to next chapter. Triangles. Twelve we have tried in the last session. In Google Classroom also I have uploaded these class worksheets. Ninth number we have tried. 9th, 12th, and one more question, 8th, we had seen in last session. So 11th number everyone will try. Prove that the parallelogram subscribing means this parallelogram will be outer portion of circle. All the four sides will touch the circle. Circle will be inside the parallelogram. Is a rhombus. Today the parallelogram subscribing a circle is a rhombus. One second. Question is, who Okay, Bhavya, please, others can also try. Last 2 minutes time. I will write in here itself question. Prove that the parallelogram circumscribing this circle is a rhombus. Done. How many of you solved the question? This question, only one. Navneet, what about you? Ajit, Anushka, Purva. Not yet. Okay. Please try. This question can also come. I got your answer, Bhavya. Let me check 1 second. The right answer is correct. So let me solve. For the instruments. Okay, good, Purva. You have also completed this question. It's got the answer. So basically, we have to prove parallelogram circumscribing a circle is a rhombus. Okay. So we can draw one. Just now. 1 second. One diagram we can have, this is circle having center O, and we can have one parallelogram. Parallelogram is basically parallel, opposite sides are parallel and equal. Opposite sides are parallel and equal. So A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. Opposite sides are parallel and equal. And we have to prove this parallelogram, which is circumscribing a circle, will be a rhombus. Correct. Let the meeting point of the parallelogram be means this will AB will be tangent, so this will touch the circle at, let me be Q R and S. So we have to prove ABCD is a rhombus. To prove ABCD basically quadrilateral is a rhombus. So you know A is external point to this circle, so this AP will be equal to AS. So first we write AP will be equal to AS. Similarly, B is external to this circle. So BP will be equal to BQ. BP is equal to BQ. Also, D is external to this circle. So DR will be equal to DS. Why we write DR? Because DR will be opposite to AB, means DC will be opposite to AB. So we write this AB, PB we have written, okay, AB. So we can write now. No problem. So this will be DR will be equal to DS, because now see AS will be added with DS. AS and DS will be added and C will be outer portion. So basically CR will be equal to CQ. Correct. So CR will be equal to CQ. So all the four sides we got, and we'll add these four equations. 1, 2, 3, 4. If we add these equations, we get AP plus BP in one, plus DR plus CR in second bracket, and here AS plus DS in one, plus BQ plus CQ in another bracket. So write the terms basically. So what is AP plus BP? So AP plus BP will be equal to AB.
AB.
And correct, DR plus CR will be CD. Carefully write the values. Second thing, AS plus DS. AS plus DS will be AD, and BQ plus CQ will be BC. Also, because in given we have this now, given ABCD is a parallelogram subscribing a circle with center O. This we can write circumscribing. Same thing we can write which were given in question, subscribing a circle with center O. So ABCD is a parallelogram, so we can write here. See, here we can write. Now we have to prove this. Now this is a basically a rhombus. So AB plus CD will be equal to AD plus BC. Now we know AB equal to CD. AB equal to CD we know, and AB equal to CD, okay, and BC equal to AD. So here we can write from this, this is fifth equation, this is sixth one. So from fifth and sixth we can write twice of AB, from equation fifth and equation sixth we get twice of AB equal to twice of which value we write, AD or BC? Both are equal. AD equal to BC, so we write any value. AD and BC are equal, so we can write BC. We can write BC, anyone we can write, or twice of this. Now in place of AB CD we can write anyone. AB equal to CD, so twice of CD also we can write. Twice of CD, right Apurva? So twice of CD will be equal to twice of this. Now AD we can write, no problem. AD and BC, anyone we can write twice of AD. So 2 cancel. So this implies AB equal to BC and CD equal to AD. See, AB equal to BC we got from the calculations. AB equal to this now BC and CD is equal to AD. But AB equal to, it is a parallelogram, so we can write AB equal to CD and BC equal to, because parallelogram is opposite sides are parallel and equal, BC equal to AD as quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Hence we can conclude AB equal to CD equal to BC equal to AD. All the four sides are equal and it is not square. All the four sides are equal, but it is not a square. A square means edge are not basically vertically, and opposite sides are equal and parallel, and here adjacent sides are also equal, but they are not basically this now. Vertex are not at 90 degree, not necessarily 90 degree because this is a parallelogram. So if vertex are 90, then it will be a rhombus, or it will be a square, because see, a square is a special case of a rhombus. So we can say all the sides are equal, hence quadrilateral ABCD is a rhombus. Hence proved. Also, this is a rhombus, this now diagonals of the rhombus bisect each other. They are not equal, but they bisect each other at 90 degree. So that concept also we can use. But normally say this is a parallelogram, means opposite sides are equal and parallel. And we have proved this now adjacent sides are also equal. That means all the sides are equal. All the sides are equal and it is a parallelogram. Means this now sides are parallel and this now all the four vertices are not perpendicular to each other. It means all the four vertices don't have this 90 degree. So ultimately only one shape will have, that is rhombus. So ABCD is a rhombus, we can conclude from here. ABCD is a will be a rhombus, because it will not be square. One more property we have, that this now diagonals of a rhombus, this now bisect each other at 90 degree. This is one diagonal, this is another diagonal. So diagonals are not equal, but they bisect, means equally they divide each other, and at 90 degree. So this is 90 degree, this will be also 90 degree, and this will be equal. This property we can also see here, but not necessary, because this will take time, because we can take, but once again we can prove all this. Once again we can, if anyone follows this method, the proof is basically we have to join this one, this all this we have to join, and we can take this now congruent, we can prove, because this is 90 degree, this will be 90, so this will be congruent, and so this angle will be equal. Again these two triangles will be congruent, so this angle will be equal, and similarly we can same process like we did in previous question. This will be 90 degree, similarly this angle also we can prove 90 degree, but not required in this case. Likely we can prove opposite this now adjacent sides are equal. So adjacent sides are equal, that means it is a parallelogram, and adjacent sides are equal, so all the sides are equal, that means it will be a rhombus. No other option, because it will not be square, only we left with rhombus. No problem. Now I'll move to next chapter, that is triangles. This was circle chapter, last question. Let me open that sheet. Why this circle is opening? Circle PDF. Okay. Suppose triangle basics, you all know, no? Triangle basics, or basics we can revise first, because I have some 4-5 questions, very basic questions of triangles. So I was thinking we can solve first those questions, then we'll see what is the questions from your this one, then concepts and questions from your textbook. One second. So this is one question, so everyone can try to solve, because basics you must be knowing. Otherwise we'll see after these 5 questions, it will not take 10 to 15 minutes. After these 5 questions we can revise the concept plus questions, because we have just started. Everyone will not answer anything, just share me the answer. These are the 5 questions. All the questions are visible, not now visible all the questions. triangle, see, time is given 30 minutes, but
so can you zoom in?
1 second. All the questions are visible now. Not visible now. Visible with options. Fine. So these are 5 questions. Just share me the options. And time is, you can say 5 to 10, 20, maximum 20 minutes, 15 to 20 minutes. Or as soon as possible, you can share me the answer. Maximum time, 15 minutes, minimum 10 minutes. Here they have given 30 minutes, means I have written only. But we can take 20 minutes time. We have basics question of circle, options are also given, means MCQs basically. So everyone will try. First diagram is adjacent to this question. Question 1, triangle ABC is given, D is parallel to BC and value is given, A 1.8 cm, EC 5.4, BD given 7.2 cm to find AD value. Actually, all the 5 questions, Namit, you have to share with me. Write this now, options. This is question 1, option C, option D, whatever options, question 1, question 2, question 3, question 4, question 5, along with option, one in one message. In chat, or you can do WhatsApp also, anyone, medium. Yes. All the answers in one message. Sujit, please try these questions because you have just joined. So all of you try these 5 questions as quickly as possible, but make sure answers are correct. 15 to 20 minutes is the time limit. I got answer from Anushka. So Anushka, you can once again you can check and verify, because still only 5 minutes.
Okay.
Yes, you have solved in 5 minutes only, so you can take one additional 5 minutes to verify these answers, so that you get full marks. Is also there for one question, 5 marks. Sorry, 4 marks. 4 marks or two marks, anyone you can take. So if you teach 2 marks, then total marks will be 10. So Bhavi, still 2 minutes are remaining. Minimum is minimum 10 minutes we can take. So just verify the answer in 2 minutes, then I will assume these are the answers. In case you want to do correction, then you can do, means Anushka has corrected one question, no problem. So after 10 minutes, this time I will assume those answers as a